Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today in this tutorial, I am going to show you how we can implement Shimmer effect or Skeleton UI in our React Native app. I am going to reload our app. And here you can see there is a loader. And here you can see that our image is getting loaded later. That time we are displaying some default image, right? So there is two things going on. The first one is the Shimmer effect or Skeleton UI loading, this thing, and after that when the content is loaded but the image is not loaded yet and we are fetching all those data from the internet from Firebase, and while it's getting loaded, that time we will display some loading UI to our user so that it can provide a better user experience to the user. So for the Shimmer effect or Skeleton UI loading, we will use a React Native package to implement it and then to display the default image before displaying the actual image, we will create a custom component to display it. So this is what we are going to do in this tutorial. And here our app is running on Android emulator. If we check over here, let's reload it. Here also we can see that we have this Shimmer effect. And then we can see that our image is getting loaded. And in the meantime, for a fraction of a second, we can see that default image which we were seeing over here little prominently. So these things are working properly for both of the platforms, and that is what we are going to implement today in our React Native social app, which we are building by using Firebase. And in our previous tutorials, I have already implemented all these functionalities, like how we can authenticate user by using Firebase authentication, how we can create post, how we can store image in storage and fetch data, all of these things. So if you are new to this series or new to my channel, then I will suggest you to check this tutorial series. Here we have implemented many more things previously, so it will definitely help you to understand how you can implement Firebase in your React Native project and how you can create all these UIs. So if you find this tutorial interesting to you, then hit the like button, subscribe to my channel for more tutorials like this, and don't forget to hit the notification bell icon so that you get notified whenever I post a new tutorial on this channel. So without wasting any more time, let's get started with the tutorial. So this is our app, and in this app we are going to implement all those things. Now let's reload this once. And here we can see that there is no loader and our image and data is appearing suddenly. So it is not a best user experience. So that's why we are going to implement those Skeleton UI and display default image before loading the image. So Shimmer effect or the Skeleton UI is pretty simple to implement. I'm going to use a package, but if you want to implement it from scratch, then also it is pretty easy to implement. There are lots of tutorials available on YouTube in which they are showing how you can implement it by using animated API from React Native or by using reanimated library to implement that effect. So I'm not going to do that. My main motto is to implement that effect quickly, and along with that the default image which will be displayed before loading this actual image. So first thing is this React Native Skeleton UI, and for that I will use this library. So this is how it will look, and I have already shown you how it will look in our app. So we can directly go to the installation steps. So here first we need to install this React Native Masked View, and if it is installed in our app then we don't need to install it, and it already installed in our app. If we go to our package.json, then we can see that Masked View is already installed. So we will not going to install that. We are going to install this package, and I'm going to use npm. So I'm going to copy it and I can paste it here. Now hit enter. So it has been installed. Now we can start implementing it. So let's see the uses. The first one is the skeleton place provider dot item, and then we have this skeleton place provider with view, and I'm going to use this one. So I can copy this one, and to check it I will use this chat screen. This is currently the blank screen, so we can get help from it. So a skeleton placeholder is present. Now we need to import it. Now save it. Now after saving it, we can see that it is getting displayed. So it's pretty simple. Now we need to just modify it to match with our UI. So here we have this image and this text data, which is similar to this area. Now we need to add this post data, which is this text content, and then the image. So after this view, we can create another view to provide those data. First, we have this wrapper view, and within this wrapper view, we will provide the actual view which will display those content. So for the style of it, I will provide width 300, height 20, and border radius 4. Let's see how it's looking. So it's not displaying that. Let's reload it. So that's how it's showing over here. So for this wrapper view, we need to provide some margin. So for the top margin, I provide 10, and for the bottom, I will provide 30. Now after this view, I will provide another view with the width of 250 pixel, and for this view, I will provide a margin top 6 pixel. Now after this text content, we will display this image section. So for the height of it, I will provide 200, and for the width of it, I will provide 350. Now let's check it. Now it's looking like this, and it's pretty similar to what we will be getting in our app UI, right? So I'm going to use it, and I'm going to use it multiple times. And then this view will be scroll view, and you need to import this scroll view from React Native. And here we cannot use this container because we need to provide this align item in content container style. So here it will be align item center, and for the style of it, I will provide flex 1, which is similar to this. And for this view, we need to change it to scroll view. Now it's properly ready to use it in our home screen. Copy it, and I can use it over here. And previously, we have this loading state, and by default this loading state is set to true, and we are setting it to false after loading the data from our Firebase database. So we can use this loading state over here to display this loader in our app before loading the actual data. So here for this loading, if it is set to true, then we will display this data, and then else if it is not set to true, that means set to false, that means our data is present, that time we will display this flat list data, which is our actual data. Before saving it, we need to import this skeleton UI over here, and which is from here, and we have this view imported from React Native, and along with it we need to use this scroll view as we are using it, right? Now save it, and now reload it. So we can see that while it's getting loaded, that time we are seeing this shimmer effect, but our images are taking little time to load, and in the meantime there is a blank space. We don't want to display that blank space. Instead, we want to display our default image, and from that default image we want to transition to the actual image, and that is what I'm going to implement now. So for that, first I'm going to create a component in our components directory. So I have created progressive image component in our components directory, and now we will create our custom component in which we will display a default image while our actual image is getting loaded. So let me create a component quickly, and the component name is progressive image. Now here we don't need this text and button. We will require animated API from React Native, and we will not require these things. And for this container background color, I will provide this color. Now after that, I will create a variable with the animated value of 0, and I will copy this again for another variable called image animated. Now after that, I will create a function called default image load, and here we will handle the default image load. So we will provide the animation from 0 to 1, and for that we will use animated timing, and we will provide two value 1, and for use native driver we will provide true. And we need to provide start to start it. Similarly, we need to copy this one for our actual image. So this one will be handle image load, and here we will use image animated. Now after that, let's create two image over here, and those images will be animated image. And here we will provide source, and we will get the source from our prop. Let me fetch those data from our prop. In props, we will get default image source, then our actual source, which is the source of our image, then some style. If we want to provide any style to this component, then we can do that by passing this style prop. And then I will give flexibility to provide any other prop, and we will destructure it by these three dots. So for the source of it, I will use this default image source. Then for the style of it, I will use this style prop, and along with it I will provide opacity, and the opacity will be default image animated, the animated value, which is 0 to 1. So that is what we are going to use over here. Now here for this image we can use onload, and for this onload we will use handle default image load. And here I want to provide a seamless transition between these two images, so I want to provide a blur effect to it. So for this I want to provide a blur radius equal to 1. Now after this default image, we want to display actual image, that will be our actual image source. And here for these images we can provide these props, so copy this for our actual image as well. And for the style of it, we will use this style provided by the prop, and the opacity will be image animated. And along with it I want to provide another style, which will be styles image overlay, and I haven't created this style yet, so I'm going to create it now. And for this image overlay position, I will provide absolute position, and I will provide 0 for top, bottom, left and right, so that it fits perfectly to our view, and it will display on top of our default image. And we don't want to blur it, so we will not provide any blur radius to this actual image. Now save it. So we are going to use it in our postcard component, in which we are displaying our post image. So instead of this post image, we are going to display our progressive image. So let me copy this line and comment it out, and we will use progressive image, and we need to import it from our progressive image component. Now here for this progressive image we can provide some props, and those props will be our default image source, then our actual image source, and then we can provide some styles. So first we need to provide default image source, and here we are going to provide a local image, and here we have that in our assets directory. So within assets we have this default image.jpg, so I'm going to use it. Then we need to provide actual image source, so that will be our URI item post image, and then we can provide some styles of it. And to provide the styles, let me check for this post image component, which I have created from this feedstyles.js file, and we are using styled components for it. So we have provided this height and width over here, along with this margin top. So let me provide that quickly over here. Okay, so we have provided all the styles for it. Now I will provide resize mode cover, and this prop we haven't defined over here. Instead we have provided these props. So by this props we are getting any kind of prop which is supported by the image API from React Native. This resize mode is supported for image API, so that's why we can use it, and it will be effective for our animated images. Now save it. Now after saving it, we can see that our default image is present over here. Now let's reload it once and check it how it is working. Okay, it's not showing the actual image, it is just showing the default image, and I think it may be because of this typo. So it will be progressive image, and that is from here. Okay, here I have provided handle default image load for both of the image. Here I need to provide handle image load for our actual image. Now after that we can see our actual image is present over here, and here we can see some issue which is from our margin top. So now it's looking perfect. Now let's reload it once. So our shimmer effect is present, then our default image, and from the default image we are transitioning to our actual image, and that is where our animation and this blur radius is doing. The transition is looking good, and if we want to provide some space between this text and this image, then we can provide that in our fade style. After our post text we can provide margin bottom 15 pixel as we have provided over here. So now it's looking as expected, right? Now let's check it final time. It's working perfectly. So this is the tutorial, guys. I hope you have learned something new from this tutorial. If you do so, then hit the like button. Let me know by commenting down below. If you have any kind of suggestion for me, then also let me know in the comment section below, and share this tutorial with your friends and colleagues. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more tutorials like this. I will see you guys in my next tutorial. In the meantime, have a great day. Goodbye.